Embarking on a journey to the cosmos has always been the stuff of dreams and science fiction. Yet in recent years, the boundaries between imagination and reality have blurred as companies like SpaceX push the limits of space exploration. However, amidst the buzz surrounding Elon Musk's brainchild, there is another player quietly making waves in the race to the stars. Allow me to introduce you to VAST, a company with audacious ambitions that just may reshape the future of space stations. While SpaceX focuses on transportation, VAST is boldly stepping up to build the modules of extraordinary space station that promises to defy expectations. In this episode, you will witness the birth of a new era in space exploration, where artificial gravity and cutting-edge technology converge to revolutionize humanity's extraterrestrial endeavors. The remarkable VAST have plans to create a first-ever commercial space station like no other. Buckle up and get ready. You're watching Adventures in Space. In a stunning revelation, SpaceX is renowned for its groundbreaking transportation capabilities, and Elon Musk himself has emphasized that they are not focused on building space stations or bases. Therefore, it comes as no surprise that another company has stepped forward to fulfill this futuristic niche. On May 10, 2023, a young company called VAST, a pioneer in space habitation technologies, announced their plans to launch the world's first commercial space station called Heaven 1. VAST's remarkably ambitious roadmap has taken everyone by surprise. Unlike other companies that have made empty promises about space stations in the near future, VAST seems to possess the necessary resources, funding, and expertise to transform their vision into a reality. However, the specific details of what VAST will be launching and their plan to achieve it by 2025 are quite intriguing. While they have lofty long-term goals, their short-term vision is equally attainable. Instead of relying on SpaceX's Starship, VAST has decided to deploy the first module of their space station using a Falcon 9 rocket. This calculated decision demonstrates VAST's determination to establish itself as a significant player in the industry. But why should we really take VAST so seriously? VAST's main focus is developing artificial gravity space stations to expand humanity's across the solar system. At least, that's the narrative they're presenting to the world through their website. Let's delve into what SpaceX has to say about them. In a recent press release, VAST announced that SpaceX would be launching what is expected to be the world's first commercial space station, fittingly named VAST Heaven 1. SpaceX's involvement in this endeavor, coupled with their plans for two human spaceflight missions to the station, clearly demonstrates the seriousness with which they regard VAST. Heaven 1, an independent and fully functional space station, will be connected as a module to a larger space station currently under development by VAST. The crew of the Dragon spacecraft, consisting of four individuals, will dock with Heaven 1 for up to 30 days while orbiting Earth. VAST's long-term goal is nothing short of groundbreaking. A 100-meter-long spinning artificial gravity space station propelled by SpaceX's Starship transportation system. To support this vision, VAST intends to conduct the world's first spinning artificial gravity experiment on Heaven 1, paving the way for future advancements. At first glance, Heaven 1 may seem unassuming and conventional, but don't be fooled by its seemingly modest appearance. VAST is on a mission to make history as the pioneer of commercial space stations, and they're taking a bold approach to secure that distinction. While other companies like Northrop Grumman, Nanorax, Blue Origin, and Sierra Space were initially seen as contenders to replace the International Space Station, VAST is shaking things up with a straightforward strategy. They're launching a basic module into orbit powered by solar energy, which will directly dock with SpaceX's Dragon spacecraft. Unlike the more complex and untested designs proposed by their competitors, such as the orbital reef with its inflatable modules, VAST is opting for a more conservative route. They're leveraging proven modules and life support systems akin to those used on the ISS. As their capabilities expand, they plan to gradually scale up their module sizes, adhering to a proven approach. The Heaven 1, a 7-meter diameter module specifically designed for SpaceX's Starship, serves as a foundation for their grand vision. it's just the beginning of a larger space station composed of multiple Starship-class modules. Now, most certainly you are captivated by the fact of having an artificial gravity at the space station. While the science behind this ambitious goal is already truly a reality, the fact is, it contradicts the core objective of space exploration. Microgravity plays a vital role in supporting numerous industries that flourish in space, such as the creation of biological organs through 3D printing and the development of innovative metallic alloys. These groundbreaking advancements can only be realized in a microgravity setting. Introducing artificial gravity in space reduces the potential for these critical innovations. Nevertheless, rotating artificial gravity space stations like the one VAST aims to construct do have a purpose of providing extended accommodations for individuals working in space. An interesting point to note is that Orbital Assembly, a company also involved in the construction of massive rotating space stations, has introduced the Voyager station as part of their plans. However, there are concerns about the viability of this station's business model due to its location in the Sun's synchronous orbit with few neighboring stations. In contrast, VAST has taken this aspect into account and devised a solution. In addition to their spinning stick station that generates artificial gravity, VAST intends to operate a growing array of co-orbital modules that freely float in zero gravity. These modules will offer an ideal environment for large-scale manufacturing, research, and tourism. By ensuring quick access to the gravitational advantages of the spinning stations, VAST successfully strikes for a balance between the benefits of microgravity and artificial gravity, thereby mitigating the adverse effects of prolonged exposure to microgravity. The extensive strategy outlined by VAST is truly impressive. It not only sets attainable short-term targets, but also establishes the foundation for remarkably ambitious future ventures. Haven 1, with its realistic objectives, serves as a stepping stone towards the widespread existence of space station fleets and the realization of massive rotating stations that were once confined to the realm of science fiction. Nevertheless, VAST has no intention of undertaking these concluding phases until the 2040s. Their plan entails a gradual construction of the station, allowing them to accumulate invaluable experience, attract investors, and gain customers throughout the process. In conclusion, VAST's entry into the space station arena promises to revolutionize space exploration. While SpaceX focuses on transportation and essentially becoming an Uber of space, VAST boldly building modules for extraordinary space stations. With VAST's focus on artificial gravity, they will eventually create a unique environment that combines both the benefits of micro and artificial gravity. They aim to cater to scientific innovation and extend accommodations for space workers, which, in my humble opinion, is truly paving the way for widespread space station fleets. With comprehensive strategy, realistic short-term goals, and ambitious long-term vision, VAST shapes the future of space exploration like never before. And without a doubt, I am betting on them today. As always, this was Georgie with Adventures in Space, and I will see you at the next one.